Hey, it's Ali Drew for BBTV. I'm here at the Steel City Gym in Sheffield, and earlier I caught up with John Doherty to see how he's rebuilding his career after his last fight. So, John, in training, just finished a training session, did a bit of sparring, just talked to me about this morning what you've been doing.
Yeah, well, obviously, I've just got back. I went on an injury from my last fight. I had to pull out of that. A minor cut of crack ribs, so I've had like 3 or 4 weeks out. I've been taking over, like doing my running and all that there, but I've done my first spar back, and I've done 6 rounds, and I'm just waiting till my rib heals and then I'm ready to go again. So just finished 6 rounds of sparring with Junaid there, and the gym's flying.
Yeah, because you were meant to fight in Russia on the 8th of May, I think it was.
Yeah.
How soon before the fight did you have to sort of pull out with the rib?
A week. I had like 2 weeks before I had sparring. I'd done it in sparring and I thought I'd have a week off of, I don't want my visas and that anyway. So I had a week off of sparring but obviously still training, and then I come back to sparring. And it was like in the 5th round that I went all the whole 5 rounds. I was doing 6 rounds sparring, I got hit a jab. And I thought, well, this is smart, and it was killing me. It was like, I never stopped sparring. I finished the sparring, but after it, it was a lot of pain. Went to the hospital, and they basically said I had a cracked rib. And I was going to just go in, but I'll just go in. But then obviously, where I've just lost my last fight, I can't do no more flip-ups. I've got to be 100% when I go in to do my fight, so I wasn't taking that chance.
How frustrating was that, so close to the sort of comeback fight? You know, you've presumably had a full camp up till that point. Yeah. How frustrating was that?
I had 12 weeks. That's the longest camp I've ever had. I usually only do 6 weeks. On my last camp, I only done 4 weeks, so that was 12 weeks of hard training, and obviously a lot of money spent in the training camp, and obviously it was hard to pull out, but I made the right choice, and I was flying in the gym, and all the boys would tell you, and obviously Grant's changed my style and from a different style to me what I was in the amateur games, you know what I mean? But a bit of box fighting, and I was just ready to showcase what I've been working with Grant, and how much I've improved, but I never got the choice to do that, so, but I'll have to wait a bit longer, and this, it gave me more time in the gym with Grant anyway, you know what I mean? It's a new coach, and I've been working for a long time now, so I'm just getting ready to let it all unleash.
Well, you've had a bit of time now since, you know, your first professional defeat in November, I think it was. Now you've had a bit of time to sort of reflect on that. How do you feel about that? Do you feel like, you know, no one wants a defeat on their record, but do you feel like you've learned from it?
Yeah, basically what I've got on my head just now that I'm no good, I'm useless. Like, that's what's in my head. Like, I've got to prove a lot of people wrong. I said my last fight, like when I fought Anthony Fox, I said I boxed terrible as well. And then obviously I went and boxed terrible again against Jack Cullen, so it's just up and down really. I've come to this gym now and I know for a fact I'm going to showcase a whole different skill of John Doherty. I was always that one punch. When I got that reputation of knocking everyone out, I didn't want to go in the ring and not get a knockout. So I've always, and when I had the Jack Cullen fight, I thought I'll knock him out. I'll take the fight on a short notice, I'll just knock him out. And obviously that's what I got put into my head. And I was thinking that all the time, and I went in there and basically Jack Cullen unstuck me, you know what I mean? And my fitness as well, but I'm not going to brag on my fitness. I only had a 4 week camp, but Jack Cullen beat me fair and well, and I've took the defeat well, and I wasn't going to come back. I was going to quit boxing, and as I said, I'm playing another interview, I was going to stop boxing, but my dad and obviously Grant and my new manager Alciester has got me back on the track, and I've got the fire back in my belly, and it's not just one of them fights where I just go and look good. I've got to look very good from doing it, you know what I mean? And basically, if you're on my weight just now, everyone else calling out, everyone wants to fight me now, because obviously everyone thinks I'm rubbish. And in my own mind, I just think I am, because you only go back by your last performance, and mine was absolutely shocking. So, but as I said, with Grant and that there, I've changed my style, and I just can't wait to get in the ring now. It's been ages, and just get back to winning ways and showing everyone what I've been working on.
Yeah, because you were a massive favourite for that fight,
yeah.
And so I presume there was, you know, a lot of pressure with that. Does the fact that you've now had that defeat and you're sort of restarting, going back to, you know, the drawing board and starting again, do you feel like the pressure's gone and it's just you can focus a bit more on what you're doing, change things without the pressure added to it?
You know what, everyone from that last fight, everyone thought I was arrogant. Like, obviously you've got to go by what you see on camera, and I look very arrogant, and I'm never like that. I'm not an arrogant person, I'm quite a nice person, do you know what I mean? And everyone was going to Grant, like some coaches are going to Grant, oh, John's very arrogant. And Grant's going, what, you're never going to be arrogant, you go by the cameras. But I got put on to build that fight up, and that's how I've come unstuck. I mean, I wish I'd never ever done that. Obviously, I was arguing with Jack Cullen, calling names, calling him useless. Well, that useless Jack Cullen beat me, you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? That's what I was saying about Jack Cullen, he's useless, and he just beat me. So what does that make me feel in my head now, you know what I mean? That's why I was going to quit. How could I come back from that defeat? But it's just how you come back and how I bounce back. You know? I mean, I know I've been beat off Jack Cullen and that, but there was a lot of things wrong in that fight, a lot. What I've not come on to too, do you know what I mean? So, like, my food, you should have seen what I was eating. I was drinking, oh man, I couldn't tell you what I was doing, but it was very bad. Obviously, I've got eating good food now. I'm literally 2 miles from the gym. Where before, I was 60 miles from the gym, so I was coming back, missing my runs because I was that tired. But listen, I've done the right move now. I've moved to Sheffield, and Grant's got me in good shape. And as you can see on my photos, I am in very good shape. And I had 3 weeks out, but I've been training for the 3 weeks, so I'm ready to go. Whenever my rib heals up, and I've just started then, it felt fine. So.
So what kind of fight are you looking for next? You know, it's, as you say, it's important for you to have a good performance. So what is the sort of steps now?
It's not going to be a journeyman. It's going to be somebody who's going to be there and going to be able to take my power and so I can showcase my skill, you know, what I'm working on. So somebody who can come forward and, I don't care who it is, to be fair with you. I just want an 8-rounder to get like my cobwebs up. I've been off six months, whatever it's been, so I've been out a long time. And the time, obviously, when I fight, I'll be 7 months from now, so it's a long time, and I've got to get my time back. Obviously, you spar and all that, but sparring's nothing like fighting, and it's completely different. So I've just got to get in the ring and just Grant obviously picks my opponents, gets them to touch my manager and tell them who's going to be, but it's obviously maybe an 8-rounder, and then an 8-minute title fight, 10-rounder after that, so see how it goes.
Are you hoping that sort of title fight is going to be this year? It's going to be sort of a quick succession of fights?
Oh, definitely this year it's going to be. I'm going to do an 8-rounder and then I'm going to fight for a title. I don't know if it's going to be a WBO or an IBF, an immediate title, whatever it is. I want a title. Obviously, everyone in the gym now has got titles. Well, Dalton's won English. Sonny has just won the world title. I mean, the gym's flying. I mean, Grant doesn't actually get the credit he deserves, what he's done with his boys. Obviously, he's had Dalton's son, you know what I mean? So he doesn't get the credit what he deserves, but obviously he's had Sonny Edwards, he's got Charlie Edwards, you know, he's got loads of boys, you know what I mean? But the gym's flying, and obviously me watching everyone winning these belts, I want a piece of these belts, you know what I mean? I want a belt to come back to the gym to show everyone, you know what I mean? It's I don't care what kind of belt it is, as long as I've got a belt around my waist, by the end of the year I'll be happy.
Yeah, and as you say, you know, it's a very, very successful gym at the moment. Yeah. And what is that like, training day in, day out here, you know, for your motivation and to keep you, because you said you wanted to retire, you didn't think you were going to box again. So how good is it having people like that around you?
Well, obviously, it's very good. That when I watched Sonny Edwards fight for the world title, I was like, I didn't know how he kept the fitness up. Like, I was thinking, like, obviously we've got resources, our running schedules and our ICC. I was thinking, is this actually going to work? Like, you've got in your mind, you're training hard, but you've got in your mind, is your fitness actually going to keep up here? And when I watched Sonny Edwards do that, I was thinking, nah. You know, when I've got 100% in Reese as well, he comes in and does a condition with us. So, and when Sonny won the world title and then Dalton won an English title, just give me that bit more, you know what I mean? Knowing I can put, I really trust Grant more. I only know Grant a few months and I can trust him anything. You know what I mean? He's a very, very nice person, but you do one thing wrong at the gym and you're gone. That's basically, that's the way it goes. Obviously, these other coaches give you a return. You do one wrong thing, you miss a session, he's highly upset with it. So you've got to show him you're 100% and I'm 100% dedicated now than what I've ever been. So.
Well, I also want to talk to you about your fellow Scotsman, Josh Taylor, winning the Undisputed titles last week, I think it was. How good was that to see, you know, a fellow Scot doing something like that, making history?
Well, hopefully, it's obviously unbelievable. Like, that's what every person wants. Is what he's done, and I don't think he's getting the credit what he gets. I don't think he does. Usually, when I wake up in the morning, I usually see, like, obviously because the fight has been on early, I go to sleep and wake up in the morning, and I usually look in the morning. I couldn't hardly see no George Taylor. Has he won here? And then I obviously won, and I was thinking he's not getting the credit what he deserves. He's only a Scottish man who's just won all the belts. What else do you want to do? Do you know what I mean? And I've just got to hopefully one day I can be on his show. I can get put on one of his shows, and George Taylor just lifted the spirit for Scotland, and all the boys from Scotland on the small little shows and building themselves up. They just look at him now and just they've got him to focus on. Do you know what I mean? I just can't believe what he's done, actually. He's won every single belt. Like, it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable.
Scottish boxing's doing well. There's a lot of Scottish guys who have got titles.
Definitely. Obviously, we had Lee McGregor here as well. I wasn't here the time he was here, but Lee's doing very well. Obviously, there was Kieran Smith. Obviously, he didn't meet up to Troy Williams, but he's still a good kid. And there's Nathaniel Collins. There's a few that they don't really know, which some small holes, which is very good. Like, Nathaniel Collins, he's on a good run just now. There's a few Scottish boys that'll probably come after me after I'm finished recording. There's loads of Scottish boys. What we can make a show from Scotland easy. And Yeah, Scottish boxing is booming at the moment.
And how excited are you now when you know when you get to fight, when you recover and you've got a fight, that the crowds are going to be back? You know, because it's been a long time since they haven't been there. But is that going to be important for you to get your supporters back?
Definitely. I felt weird in fight camp as well. When I was fighting, when I fought Anthony Fox, I felt like a spark, and I didn't have the same. Like when I hurt somebody, I just had the same. When everyone's shouting me on, and it's just completely different. I don't have a lot of fans anyway, but them fans do make a lot of difference. And obviously, when you come up the ring and after it, you've got everyone coming up to you. That makes it a little bit better as well. I mean, when you're coming up the ring, it's just like you've just finished a spa. Oh, we're done. We're going home now. Let's be done with the spa. That's what it felt like. You know what I mean? So it'd be good to get fans back in. And not even that. I'm just looking forward to boxing again and showing everyone what I've been working on with Grant. You know what I mean? It's you're going to see a completely different John Doherty, obviously. Completely two different coaches, Tony Sims and Grant's two different coaches, do you know what I mean? And obviously Tony's doing very well with the boys, that gym's flying at the moment as well.
A lot of that's done there.
I mean, Conor Benn's doing very well. Matt and Jay Ward's fighting this weekend, so I'm hoping he needs the world title, and he's been on the edge that long. He's one boy, I hope he wins the world title. I'm backing him. Like out of that gym at the most to win a world title, because obviously he's just been there the most. Same with John Ryder, all the boys. I'm backing them all. Felix Cash, do you know what I mean? I'm still talking to them, I'm still powering them, do you know what I mean? And I wish Tony Sims' gym, the whole lot of them to win the world title, do you know what I mean? The gym's booming, but I've had a new start now, and I'm just looking forward to getting in there now.
Well, looking forward to seeing you getting back in the ring. Thank you for talking to me, and good luck with your recovery, and then I'm very excited to see you get in a fight.
No problem. Thank you very much. Thanks for the interview.